Hey everyone, Fergie here with RecordingCrave.com. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today. I'm dealing with a bit of a cold for the last 2 or 3 days, so if my voice goes out or if I sound a little different, that is why. Hopefully I won't sneeze in your ear. In this video, I want to talk about using the H delay to bring a little life to a guitar track. Let me pull up the H delay here. My normal method for recording delay on my guitar is to run it through my effects loop on my amp and then print it as I record. This time I did it a little different for a couple reasons. One, I wanted to do it different because sometimes when you get stuck in a rut of doing the same thing the same way all the time, often get the same results. And if they're good results, that's great. But sometimes if you're going after something different, then you got to try new things. So let's take a listen to the track and how it sounds without delay, just the dry signal. Well, I like the tone of the amp and the way it sounds coming in, but it needs a little life to it. The playing is fine. It's a chordal type solo, a bit U2-ish, but not quite U2-ish, basically a chordal solo. So let's go ahead and put the delay on as it's playing to see what it does to the sound. What it did right away, if you can hear it through YouTube, is it took it from being dead center to spreading it left and right on the echo. And I have the feedback or the repeat set at a very low repeat. I didn't want it too much. I just wanted it maybe just once or twice in one and one in the other. I didn't want too many. And then the tempo is set up to the tempo of the song, which is 108 beats per minute. As far as the dry and the wet, that was a little bit experimenting. Took me about 30 seconds to find out where I really wanted the wet signal to be. And then the overall output, which is basically volume of it. And then the analog setting, have it set at 4. The high pass filter I ran up a little bit, just to cut some low end off of the repeats. And then having this ping pong setting engaged ping pongs it back left and right, which gives it that nice wide sound and creates dimension and space inside of that guitar sound. And what I noticed right away, it created the perfect pocket for that guitar part to sit in as it played. Let's listen to it again. When I stopped Pro Tools, you could hear the echo go back and forth and how it doesn't repeat that many times, just basically once in one side and maybe twice on the other. It works perfect for this song, and it adds life and it adds space and dimension. And like I said, it just sits in that little pocket that sounds like it was meant to be. Now, if I would have recorded the delay through my amp and printed it down, it would have sounded fine, but I would have lost that ping pong effect that I'm getting here, which sounds really good. Now, this is something I won't do all the time because I think you can abuse it, but every once in a while, and certainly on different things, whether it be voices or guitars or keyboards, it works really well. But it does have a potential to be abused if you do it too much, but it worked great this time. So hopefully that'll give you some ideas, and you can do this on so many different instruments, as I said previously. Just experiment with it and have fun with it. Obviously, you're going to set all these settings to taste. Everything's done to taste, to your personal taste, maybe to your producer's taste, or, you know, it's got to fit the song too. That's the other part of it. So anyway, this is Fergie saying thank you so much for watching today. Again, I appreciate it. I love it if you subscribe, and we will see you in the next video.